عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي كان موجودا قبل حدوث الأشياء ويبقى بعد فناء الأشياء، تفرد بالأولية والقدم ووسم كل شيء ما عداه بالفناء والعدم كما قال عز شأنه، كل شيء هالك إلا وجهه وكل نفس ذائقة الموت، وقال كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنام سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا أبي القاسم محمد. وآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين، واللعنة الدائمة على أعدائهم أجمعين. من الآن إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد، فقد قال الله في كتابه الكريم: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وبالآخرة هم يوقنون. صلوات. So we are discussing Dua Makarimul Akhlaq of Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam. This is a supplication that Imam, our fourth Imam, has taught us to make us able to elevate our status in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a good believer with excellent manners and high morals. Makarim al-akhlaq, because akhlaq is everything. Morals, manners in Islam is the goal of everything. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. I have been sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this reason, one reason. What is the reason? لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ, so that I can complete the moral excellence. The moral excellence should be completed by the prophets, by the message that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us through all the prophets, and especially last prophet. Akhlaq, good manners, behavior. This is the whole thing. When you pray, when you fast, when you go to Hajj for pilgrimage, whatever you do, the ultimate goal for that is that you should have good manners. How to deal with people, how to speak with people, how to sit, how to walk, how to talk, how to everything in your life. So akhlaq is the goal of everything. And that's why when we talk about taqwa in Islam, iman, taqwa, Islam, yaqeen, all those terms that Quran has used, the purpose is that you be a good person first, a good human being. If you are a really good human being, then you can claim to be a good Muslim. If you say, I'm a good Muslim, but you're not a good human being. You say, I'm a Muslim, I'm a Muslim, you know, I'm a believer, I'm a mu'min. But your behavior doesn't show that. It means this is just a claim. It's not true that you are a Muslim. A Muslim should be a person whose behavior should be complete. Good behavior. Should have a good manners, really. and he should know the ethical values, Islamic ethical values, human ethical values, and should practice them in his life. And that's why in this dua, Imam starts with asking Allah to complete our iman. So first sentence that he asked was, in last week we discussed that, وَبَلِّغْ بِإِيمَانِي أَكْمَلَ الْإِيمَانِ وَاللَّهُ make me reach to the most perfect faith. Most perfect faith and belief. Iman means faith. So everybody who is a Muslim especially, right, he claims to be a believer, believes in Allah, believes in the Prophet, believes in the Day of Judgment. Faith and belief, iman. But iman has levels. And Imam is asking and teaching us to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first thing we should ask, he is starting his dua with this first sentence. Oh Allah, complete my iman. I don't want an iman, I don't want a faith which is incomplete and I remain in doubts and I don't have a good and complete, you know, faith. Akmal al-iman, the best level of iman. I want to reach there. And before this sentence, originally he started with Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. Remember, 2 weeks ago we discussed that. So he is asking Allah to send his blessings on the best of his creation in this world, in the whole universe, and they are Muhammad, the last prophet, and his progeny. And he says, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. And I said this is the best dua, best, shortest, and the best supplications ever, especially in the day of Jum'ah, on Fridays. Just keep repeating this supplication. So why he started with that? Because he wanted to show us that when we ask something for ourselves, so we should have a good role model for us. So they are the best role models for iman, for yaqeen, for good behavior, for good akhlaq. They are the best people. So we want to be like them. We want to follow them. Muhammad Ali Muhammad, they are the best people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have ever created. بَلِّغْ بِإِيمَانِي أَكْمَلَ الْإِيمَانِ Allah, make me reach to the highest and the best level of iman. Why? Because iman and faith has levels, as I said. The first thing in iman is Islam. Islam is before iman. When some people came to the Prophet and said, قَالَتِ الْأَعْرَابُ آمَنَّا. Some people from the villages came and said, oh Allah's Prophet, we believe, آمَنَّا. We have iman. See the term iman and term Islam. I explained that earlier. So they said, we believe. We have iman. We became mu'min. So the ayat revealed, this verse was revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is in Quran, قَالَتِ الْأَعْرَابُ آمَنَّا قُلْ لَمْ تُؤْمِنُوا. Tell them, no, you are not mu'min yet. وَلَكِنْ قُولُوا أَسْلَمْنَا. Don't say آمَنَّا, say أَسْلَمْنَا. Don't say we are mu'min, say we are Muslim. Muslim, as a Muslim, yes, you can claim to be Muslim. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah. Yes, you are a Muslim. So we accept you as a Muslim, but not a mu'min. Why? Because Quran says, وَلَمَّا يَدْخُلِ الْإِيمَانُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. Because you are saying la ilaha illallah, you're saying Muhammadur Rasulullah. You, with your tongue, accepting Islamic faith. But this faith Lamma yadkhul al-iman. It didn't enter to your heart yet. So when whatever you say with your tongue, it enters your heart, it turns into iman. See, first level is what you're saying with your tongue. Just claim. It's fine. When you're saying something, you're claiming. So in first step, we have to accept your claim. You say, I'm Muslim. Okay, fine. You are a Muslim. Alhamdulillah. But are you a mu'min? وَلَمَّا يَدْخُلِ الْإِيمَانُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ Iman enters the heart. Now, who knows the heart? Who can enter the heart to see if you are a mu'min? Nobody can say, no, you are not a mu'min. Why? Because I don't know whether you believe, you know, really with your heart or just with tongue. So heart, Allah knows. But the reflection of your heart should be visible to others. Then it becomes real iman. It is true that it is in your heart. Just like there is a room. And it's closed from all sides. It has windows. And you are standing outside. And without looking in the room, without going into the room, from outside and standing, you can say, oh, there is a bulb there, and it is lit. How do you know there is a bulb inside? How do you know there is a tube light inside? So because I can see the light coming out from this windows. So the reflection of light telling me that there is a source of light inside. Same thing about iman. If you have iman in your heart, it should show to others by your behavior, by your akhlaq, by your good manners, by your actions. It will show that, yeah, see, the light of iman is coming out from his heart through his actions. And there, you know, that is why when our infallible leaders, our a'imma alayhim as-salam, have explained what faith is, what belief is, so they said, al-imanu iqrarun bil-lisan. Iman is, first step is to acknowledge your faith with your tongue. You say, I'm a Muslim. I believe in Allah. I believe in the Day of Judgment. When you said this, this is iqrarun bil-lisan. You are acknowledging with your tongue. What is next? Wa amalun bil arkan. And you should amalun practice what you believe. If you believe there is a God, there is a creator, there is Allah, then your behavior should show every time. You cannot do anything wrong, right? Why? Because if you know that there is a police and the police car is standing there, are you going to do something wrong which make you deserve a ticket? No. Are you going to cross the red light in front of a police, or even go fast over the limit in front of police? No. Why? Because you know there is a police. He is looking to me. He is going to punish me. He is going to give me a ticket if I do this. So your certainty of existence of the officer stops you from doing wrong. How much you believe in Allah? How much? Not even this much as you believe in the existence of policemen? So if somebody knows that there is Allah and he is watching me, he is looking to me, he will never do anything wrong. So simple. The more you have faith, the stronger faith you have, the better your akhlaq will be. Because you, every time you will find yourself accountable to someone who is watching you all the time. Your behavior might change when you see people are there, or if people are not there. This will make difference in your behavior. At home you are a different person, outside you are a different person. Why? Because your actions are for people. But when your actions become for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then your behavior will never change, neither inside nor outside. You will be the same person outside as you are inside, and you will be inside the same person as you are outside. Why? Because you're not caring about people who are watching you, caring about someone who is going to reward you or punish you on the day of judgment. So iman is something very important. This is the base for everything. Your faith. The faith is strong, your behavior is good. Now, the third level, originally it should be the first one in description of iman. وَتَصْدِيقٌ بِالْجِنَانِ. And whatever you say with your tongue, whatever you do, you practice what you said with your tongue is iman, but the base of all these two is تَصْدِيقٌ بِالْجِنَانِ. You believe with your heart. You know in your heart that what you believe is right. And what you are doing is correct. Bil jinan, with your heart. Your heart is telling you, yes, you are right. Yes, Allah is there. So the levels of iman actually are based on how you believe in your heart in something. In Allah, in Rasul, in Imam, in the Day of Judgment. In whatever you believe, in your heart, how much you believe. It should be doubtless, strong. When you are strong in your iman, your faith, inside your heart believes that, then you say it in your tongue and you practice it with your limbs. This is the whole Islam. This is the whole iman. So iman is three levels. Tasdiqun bil jinan, iqranun bil lisan, tasdiqun bil jinan, amalun bil arkan. Your heart, your tongue, and your limbs should show that you are a believer. There are so many details about iman. You know, the whole Quran is speaking about this. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. All the time just, calling the people who are believers. And even in Surah Al-Asr that always we read, and I'm going to read now, after first sermon and Fridays, it says, "Wal asr inna al-insana lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu." See, Allah says everybody is in loss. Every human being is in loss. Illa alladhina amanu, except those who believe. Wa amilu salihat, and who do good deeds. So iman, faith, always comes with good deeds. Everywhere in the Quran. In some places, Quran has mentioned amal, good deeds, before iman. For example, من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن. Whoever does good deeds, whether he is a man or woman, he will get his reward for his good deeds or her good deeds. But what he said? وهو مؤمن. With the condition of iman. So iman and amal, faith and your practice goes hand in hand. You cannot separate them. And when your iman, whatever level of iman you have, the next is to increase in your yaqeen, certainty. Be sure about what you believe in. Should have no doubt. See, in the first line in Quran, when Quran starts, it starts with this. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. If you believe the Quran is Allah's book, So you should have no doubt at all. A little doubt will damage your faith and your iman. No doubt. La rayba fi. This is the first thing Allah said in Quran. While you know, this is the first sentence. Alif lam mim dhalika al-kitab la rayba fi. It has no rayb. And in the first page, see the first page, first line, la rayba fi. And the last line, five ayat. There are five verses in the beginning which speaks about a mu'min, a believer, how a believer should be. And who is a believer? In these five verses, so for in first verse, it says there should be no doubt. A mu'min has no doubt in his heart at all. A muttaqi, a person who is a pious person, a mu'min, a believer, should have no doubt. And in the end, وَبِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ يُوقِنُونَ. See? And in akhirah, they have yaqeen. They are sure about akhirah. They have certainty, highest level of certainty about akhirah. Akhirah means the day of judgment. And see, this is the eloquence of Quran, subhanAllah. About Quran, he said, there is no doubt. While it's almost the same thing. Almost same thing, right? No doubt, and somebody is certain. He has no doubt, and he is certain. Both are same thing. But in Quran, not same thing. When Quran uses any word, it has some reason behind it. For Quran, it says no doubt because people have showed doubt in Quran. In Quran, in the beginning, is saying no. Quran is something that has no doubt. If you have any doubt, come and we'll clear that doubt logically. So how can you clear your doubt? With logic. And logically, scientifically, with regular calculations, you will go and find out that Quran is Allah's book, with no doubt. We can prove it in any way you like. But akhirat, day of judgment, can you prove it scientifically? No, not with science. So Quran should be proven logically. Yes. If you are not able to prove that this is Allah's book logically, with reason, it means you are not a strong mu'min, or you don't have that knowledge that you can claim to be a good mu'min or on a good level of iman. A good level of iman, if you have, you should be able to prove to anybody who doesn't believe in Quran, say, no, it is Allah's book, and this is the proof, and this is the evidence, and this is the reason. And there are. That's why Quran said, no doubt. But in the day of Akhirah, he said, yuqinun. They believe with yaqeen, with certainty, that there is a day of judgment. What is the difference? Because the day of judgment is hard for you. Of course, there are ways to prove, you know, but not the way you can prove Quran logically, totally, with confidence that, yes, this is Quran. Ask me a question about it. But day of judgment, prove it scientifically? No. That's why between these two, no doubt, and they have certainty, there is a word. يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. They believe in unseen. So there are levels that you have to go through, those levels, in order to reach the level of certainty and yaqeen. So yaqeen is greater than iman. Even greater than iman bil-ghayb. Iman bil-ghayb means they believe in unseen. You didn't see anything. Quran, I can see it. I see Quran. I see the wonders there in Quran. In every single ayat, there are amazing things I can see. So visible things, tangible things. But there are certain things that I cannot see. Day of judgment, I never saw. Jannat, Jahannam, all those, what we hear, barzakh, what will happen after death? What will happen in the grave? I don't know. It is all hidden things. They are invisible things. They are ghaib. When they are ghaib, unseen. But still I believe in it. Why? Because there is a logical reason I have to believe in those things which I have never seen. Through the things, the miracles that I saw, and one of the miracles is Quran. So through these, I believe in unseen. And unseen is Quran. You know, unseen is anything which I have never saw. It's ghaib. يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة. And with this iman, then the practice. يقيمون الصلاة. They pray. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. And whatever we have given them, they spend out of anything, any good thing we have given them. It could be money, it could be their skills, it could be their knowledge, it could be anything good, any bounty that we have given them, they've shared that bounty with others people, you know. So they give the right of Allah, give the right of people. And in the end it says, وَبِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ يُوقِنُونَ. أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدًى مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. So, بِالْآخِرَةِهُمْ يُقِنُونَ. They believe, they have yaqeen. So, the word yaqeen is used after iman. It means iman is greater level of, yaqeen is greater level than iman. And iman is greater level than Islam. So, when the people came and said, we are Muslims, he said, no, you are not Muslim. Don't say we are Muslim. Say, they said we are mu'min. They said, don't say mu'min, say we are Muslims. Why? Because iman didn't enter in your heart. It means iman is greater than Islam. But here in ayat, yaqeen is greater than iman. And we have so many riwayat and very interesting, inshallah, if we get chance, we'll discuss them. But see in this, to conclude it, for today, Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam. In his dua, Makarim al Akhlaq, he first, after sending the blessings on Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad, what he said? He said, وَبَلِّغْ بِإِيمَانِ أَكْمَلَ الْإِيمَانُ Allah. There are so many sentences, and every sentence is great for us to change our life. It will make really difference in our life, every single sentence. Oh Allah, make me reach the highest level of iman, akmal al-iman, the most perfect iman, asking Allah. It, most perfect means there are levels of iman which are not perfect, but I want to be to the level of perfection in iman. Next is what? وَجْعَلْ يَقِينِ أَفْضَلَ الْيَقِينِ. And make my yaqeen, my certainty, the best certainty ever. Means with no little doubt, I should believe in everything that you send. And of course, yaqeen comes through knowledge and through logical analysis. And alhamdulillah, Islam is proven by reason, by logic, by science, by anything, you know. Islam is attractive for people who have intellect. So intellectuals, if really reflect in Quran and Islamic teachings, they will for sure accept the truth and they can, you know, elevate their yaqeen in Islam and its teachings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a complete iman and give us highest levels of yaqeen, inshallah.